Moving down the aisle, Shigem sees the only available seat is next to a surly old man whose bag is half occupying the seat. "May I?" Shigem asks, indicating the bag. The old man moves the bag off after a second. Shigem nods thanks and sits down, emitting a sigh of fatigue as he does so, since it happens he's been on his feet for quite a while today. The man mumbles something not quite audible. "I'm sorry?" Shigem asks, inclining his head towards him. The old man growls in reply as he repeats himself, "Is there going to be a lot of sighing?" Shigem looks at him for a few moments, then realizes he must be referring to Shigem's sigh of fatigue upon sitting down just now. The evident assumption that this sigh was caused by the man's slowness in moving his bag is so silly that Shigem just speaks aloud his own reflex, "Oh, please!" Like a shot, the man rasps back, "Lady, cool it." Shigem's mouth falls open. How even more ridiculously silly! It's clear, however, that the situation is quite unsalvageable already, after no more than a couple of exchanges each. Reflecting on this unsalvageability, Shigem is bored, irritated, and amused in such equal measures that he finds his urge to express each of these three emotions is precisely cancelled out. The only thing to do is to whip out a book from his shoulder bag and stare into it with a furious cool, which he proceeds to do. So little is he focusing on the book's pages, however, what with all this ridiculousness, not to mention the flustered indignation beneath his furious cool, that several more seconds elapse before it occurs to Shigem that he should perhaps check whether he is holding the book the right way up. But too late, alas. "You may want to hold the book the right way up," growls the man dryly. "Oh, that does it," says Shigem, standing up again. "I didn't want to sit down anyway." "Great, I'll take your seat," says Kim, and sits in his place. "Thanks for warming it up."